lovely people. Welcome back to Ravi's Focus Hive. COVID has caused everybody to work from home. The teams have dispersed. Nobody is in one location. Everybody is in their homes. So it's all distributed teams right now. And managing these teams are becoming really difficult every day. And meeting the deadlines, meeting the goals are even more tasking. So how do you lead your team to success is one of the important questions that we all are looking an answer for. And today I'm going to share three modes that will help you to drive your team towards success. While I was reading the summary of the book, I stumbled into these three concepts and I got so inspired that I also wrote an article on LinkedIn. I've already published it a couple of hours back, so I'm going to link that in this video so that you all can read it. I've shared my personal experience, my own story in that article, and kind of tried to draw some parallels so that it's easier for all of us to understand and relate to it, and maybe start using it in our own ways. Not taking much time of yours, I will straight away come to the point. So most of the time we are in dilemma as to how should we drive our teams to achieve a certain goal, right? And what's the best method to do that? So this book called Corporate Chanakya outlines it. Though if you go online and search for driving team towards success, motivating your team or inspiring your team, you'll get plenty of articles around it. People have many items listed in there, which would, some are really good examples, some are really good points that you can pick from and imbibe in and incorporate in your teams and see good results. But I'm just going to talk about these three modes that have been described in this book called Corporate Chanakya. That kind of resonates with me because if you read the LinkedIn article, you'll know that it resonates because I have tried to use it and most of the time it has yielded good results for me. So that's the whole reason why I'm sharing it with you. So these three are, number one is instigation. So you poke someone, you kind of trigger the switch in your employee or your team to do certain task. So you instigate them, right? A bad example is, well, forget about it. Let's not talk about bad examples at all, right? Let's just talk about good things. So you instigate people. Sometimes we we press some buttons in our people to get them refocus, to get them do certain things which they are not doing it, or maybe they are too lazy to get to it. We just sometimes show them if they don't do it, what will happen, right? So we instigate it. So that is an important aspect. Do we want to do it all the time? Choice is ours, right? And also the person on the other side, whether they want or they need instigation or not. If they need instigation, we'll give it to them, right? The second one is motivation, which I believe is used 80% of the time. Anybody, everybody, always using motivation to drive their teams. And motivations are in form of awards, rewards, some recognition, some certificate, holiday package, some trophy, whatever. I mean, I've got a trophy there, I might show you. So those are motivations for us, done by our team, our managers. We also do that to our team. Show them or give them a motive to achieve a goal, right? Performance review. We give them a goal, certain numbers, certain parameters that they have to achieve in order to be categorized as a good performers. So that's again a motive. We are giving them a motive to do something. So when we give somebody a motive, that means we are trying to motivate them to do it. And the third one is inspiring people, which in my opinion is of highest importance and very difficult. And why I say it's very difficult is because it should come from within, and it can come from within for me. I can inspire myself from within, for myself, not you, not someone else, right? Maybe I get inspired and I say something or I do something that may inspire you from your within. So that's why it's super difficult. However, that's one of the major questions we are, or the whole world is figuring out, how to move your teams from being motivated or to driving them to get motivated to a state where they are inspired to do certain things. Now, let's talk about inspiration a little bit more. Why? Because it's of super importance and it is the way, the best way to drive success for your team, your team members, for yourself, for anybody. Now, as a leader, as a manager, how do you inspire people? First of all, you have to be inspired yourself. You have to be a self-righteous person. You cannot be an hypocrite, number one. And you also need to read and understand the needs of your employees and team. And the moment you understand that, it is easy after that, because you will know what will inspire them. If you are able to cater to their needs, which gets them moving, and if you are able to do that, you will be able to inspire them. Now, I'm not talking about awards, I'm not talking about salary, I'm not talking about promotion. There is one basic need of human nature, which is to understand the whole idea of my being. Why am I here? What am I doing? Why am I doing? So, as an employee, if I'm working for you or somebody is working for me, they also have the same question. And if they don't know the answer, they will not be inspired by your goals, by your values. So in order to inspire someone, you need to make sure that you understand their needs. And the bare minimum is you should know that they want to know that their work, whatever they are doing, in some way or form affecting the main goal of the company. If you are able to draw a connection between these two and show your workforce that everything that you do matters and everything that you do positive has a positive impact on the company's results, will inspire your team, your employee to do great. I've seen that in my own experience, and I've shared that in the article. Go have a look at it. And I understand we all kind of get bound by metrics, goals, numbers. But at the end of the day, we all are working together to achieve a certain goal. We ourselves need to understand what I am driving to make this team do. How is that going to affect the actual goal of the company? I need to get that clarity. Get that clarity as a leader and then give that clarity to your team. With these three modes that we are speaking about, again, I wouldn't say that You have to choose any one of them to drive your team, but it's more of a mix and match. You have to take half a glass of this and a half a glass of that and a full glass of that, put everything together, mix it well, and end result. That's how it works, and it's not a set formula. You don't have a set equation of using instigation, motivation, inspiration. You have to understand the team dynamics and what are their needs and what are their wants and what triggers them and what doesn't trigger them. And all of that you have to understand very quickly and then come up with a actual equation that is going to help your team deliver success. And when you come to that magic equation, you will see how your team functions like a mean machine and gives you amazing result. If this doesn't work for you, come back to me and we'll discuss. Till then, have a great time. Bye-bye now.